Namaskar everyone. In today's class, we are going to discuss the other important form of poetry, that is ode. After this class, you will be able to discuss the meaning, the characteristics, the structure, and the various types of ode. And also, you will be able to analyze the significance of ode in literature. An ode is a form of lyric poetry which is based on a grave theme and follows a definite structure. Like its parent form, the lyric, the ode is of Greek origin. An ode is a long poem, serious in subject, elevated in style, and elaborate in its stanzaic structure. It is usually in the form of an address to the object or the person about which or whom it is written. Let's have a look at the characteristics of the ode. It is exalted in subject matter and elevated in tone and style. The poet is serious both in the choice of his subject and in the manner of its presentation. He must show himself at the height of his power. It is longer than the lyric. In the ode, the expression of the emotion is expected to be much more consciously elaborate, impressive, and diffuse. It is often addressed directly to the being or object it treats of. The opening line sometimes contain an apostrophe or appeal which may be repeated again in the course of its treatment. An ode has for its theme an important jubilee event like a national jubilee or the coronation of a king or the death of a distinguished person. The Greek ode had two important types. First one is Dorian ode and second is Horatian ode. The Dorian ode is so called as it originated from the district Dorian. Dorian ode was choric and it was sung to the accompaniment of a dance. Its structure was borrowed from the movements of the dancers. It consisted of three parts. The first part is strophe. Strophe is a stanza form during the recitation of which dancers made a turn from the right to the left. A similar stanza form known as antistrophe, during the recitation of which the dancer made a counter turn from the left to the right. And the third stanza form that is different from the previous two, known as apod, during the recitation of which the dancers stood still. This sequence of strophe, antistrophe and an apod could be repeated any number of times in an ode of this type, from its brilliant use by the ancient Greek poet Pindar. The Dorian ode is more usually known as the Pindaric ode. The second type of ode is the Lesbian or Horatian ode. The Lesbian ode was named after the island of Lesbos, where it was originated. It was simpler in form than Pindaric ode and proved easier for poets to follow. It consists of a number of short stanzas, similar in length and arrangement. The treatment is direct and dignified and clearly developed. Lesbian ode was popularized in Latin by two great Roman poets, Horace and Catullus. Except for a few attempts in the Pindaric form or Horatian form, the English ode followed a course of its own as regards subject matter, style, treatment, and outlook. It is either regular, consisting of a series of exactly similar stanzas like the odes of Shelley and Keats, or irregular, when each stanza follows a different arrangement, as in Wordsworth's Immortality Ode and several of the odes of Tennyson and Robert Bridges. So this is all about today's topic. Thank you.